What's good? What's good? I'm back. You're truly one and only Paul Pickett, host of the Paul Pickett Podcast, aka Triple P, aka the Common Sense Podcast, your source for music, sports, politics, world events, and much, much more. Today I'm going to react to Joe Budden's and the crew talking about Lil Baby canceling shows because of his low ticket sales. Go figure. Before we do that, though, I want to give you a word from Dizzle Brand Premium Luxury Liqueur. This is going to be, I think, a Dizzle meets Langer Juice advertisement. Let's get into it. That's right. That was Dizzle Premium Luxury Liqueur. I actually love that one. It's got that great vibe to it. As Dizzle meets Langer Juices. Dizzle is a premium luxury liqueur mixed with agave, tequila, cognac, and orange liquor mango mix. Just throw your Dizzle on ice and it's nice. If you want to order your very own bottle or bottles of Dizzle Premium Luxury Liqueur, go to DizzleBrand.com, click on our locations. Click on one of the top three website links. I recommend Emilio's Beverage. It's the cheaper link. Must be 21 and over. Shipping and handling is included. Below that is locations in California, Oklahoma, Kansas, and the number one selling state for Dizzle Brand right now, which is Arkansas. And don't forget about the Dizzle Brand merch. Go to DizzleBrand.com. Click on merchandise store. Or go to Etsy.com, E-T-S-Y.com, and search for Dizzle Brand. And the Dizzle Brand gummies as well. Go to DizzleNova.com. Link is in the description. I repeat, go to DizzleNova.com for them Dizzle gummies. And I'm not going to lie. I didn't know what to expect, but they're good. Them jokers got a little kick to them. All right, let's get into it. Lil Baby's low ticket sales. I had to cancel shows. I know I'm not paying for Lil Baby concert. Let's keep it moving.
Canceled a bunch of days for his tour.
Yeah.
What does it mean? React.
He ain't had no big slaps in a minute.
I was about to say, has he had anything
like,
frequently?
It didn't look like I said it when I first saw it. This is not a tour that I, as a fan of his, this is not a tour that I would rush out to go see.
Was there anybody else on it?
Yeah, he has, I think Glow's on there. Y'all can talk about the other names on there.
Why did they think they're canceling it?
But that's why you wouldn't want to go, is because the other names that run.
Well, when you if you don't have the slaps like that to perform, like I just saw Lil Baby perform with Chris Brown on tour, and I he did okay.
Okay.
The supporting acts will kind of make up for a lot of that too,
right?
And if it's you got a person who has maybe one record, like I don't even, or some other acts that I don't even know, it's like I'm not rushing out to get this to go to this tour.
I'm with him. Like, I'm not paying to go watch OK. I'm not paying to watch OK. I've seen KRS-One perform and literally was the last person to get into the door, turn around and look, there's KRS-One. And, you know, me being me, like, I don't treat him like superstars. I called him by his real name and, you know, gave me a fist bump and not a second later, dude was on the stage, you know, whoop, whoop, that's the sound of the police. I mean, getting into it. I've seen Jordan Lucas perform, amazing. Who else have I seen perform? I mean, I've seen a lot of old schoolers perform, and it's not always amazing. It's not always amazing. Styles P, that was pretty amazing. Rick Ross and Gunplay did a show one time in Fayetteville. That was pretty amazing. Seeing Wu-Tang in Fayetteville in Chapel Hill. That was pretty amazing. DJ Premier just doing the turntables. But, like, nobody want to go pay, you know, a lot of money to go watch OK. Average.
Yeah, but off namesake, wouldn't you think that Lil Baby would fare better in an arena tour?
Not necessarily.
I can tell you what arena he's not selling out, and that's the Crown Coliseum. And I don't even know if that's really an arena, but I don't think he would sell that out. I really don't. The only person that sold out the Crown Coliseum on the hip-hop side is the hometown hero, J. Cole. J. Cole's the only person, and J. Cole sold it out and brought out Drake and Jay-Z, but nobody knew he was bringing out Drake and Jay-Z. He literally had Jeremiah, and I forgot the other rapper's name. He's from the West Coast. I'm not too big on him. But J. Cole sold it out because it was J. Cole. He surprised brought out Drake and Jay-Z. And they literally left and went straight to the airport, you know what I'm saying? Which is right next to the Coliseum. But yeah, like Fayetteville is already a tough, tough crowd to sell out.
No, not necessarily. Okay, it's 20,000 people, yo.
It's you a need Glorilla, the Kid Leroy, Gloss Up, Rilo Rodriguez,
I know Rilo,
Honcho.
Whoa. And I just thought of the other artist J. Cole had. It was YG. YG, Jeremiah, J. Cole, and he brings out Drake and Jay-Z. Now, that's the show. And the way that he surprised everybody at Fayetteville was like, even better, because like Fayetteville is a little too small to book Drake or Jay-Z. It's just a little too small. And some people was like, why they didn't stay in the Ville? There's no hotel big enough and extravagant enough and lavish enough for Drake and Jay-Z. They literally have to rent out a whole hotel probably, which is just a complete waste of money.
Oh, okay. Y'all wasn't trying to sell it out. that's what that tell me real quick. y'all wasn't trying to sell that out at all. Respectfully,
arenas?
Of course.
Yeah.
Respectfully, of course. You talking about an arena tour, you better roll
that's
some
a pavilion. Names, that's a yeah. pavilion tour. Mm-hmm. Like even yeah. And even that, I told y'all when I went to see Chris Brown and Lil Baby, outside of the major markets, they were doing amphitheaters, which... For Chris Brown, is not he don't do those. So
yeah, because I remember before COVID when we were helping artists get opening slots, they had some Chris Brown dates, and one of them was at the Phoenix Suns Arena, which is it's a basketball arena. That's arena tour, So yeah.
So now Lil Baby is headlining the tour. And you got your supporting acts on the tour ain't really got no slaps like that.
Gotcha.
And you're trying to sell arena
seats out.
If the music.
You know what, though? That's an excuse. That's an excuse. Because I just said J. Cole sold out with just YG and Jeremiah. And I guarantee you bring YG and Jeremiah without J. Cole, they ain't selling out shit in the Ville. So J. Cole sold it out. J. Cole sold it out. And then made the event even bigger than it was by bringing out Drake and Jay-Z. And when Jay-Z come out, allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Ho. Yeah, so it's an excuse. It just goes to show you that these artists nowadays, their music is not timeless. It's not classic. They're not like, they just can't really carry that big weight, that, like, I remember when everybody's like, Lil Baby the best rapper in the game. I mean, maybe for a year, but like, he wasn't the best. He was probably the hottest rapper in the game for a year. That doesn't make you the best, Like, I guarantee Busta probably could sell out more than a cat like Lil Baby right now. And he's going to have acts around him, too, that are really going to bring in some nice fans as well. But, yeah, it just goes to show you, like, these cats, a lot of them are overrated, man. They're just pumping out so much music in an oversaturated music world, you would think that they're just greater than they are. They're not. I guarantee 10 years from now, ain't nobody going to be talking about no little baby.
Did it strike fucking Rolling Loud would be calling Spotify their damn self. People would get on the phone and try to pony up some money and find out how we could fix this.
And see, that's the other thing I think happens. You get these names who headline festivals, and you kind of get a little, okay, we had X amount of thousands here at this festival, and you think I could sell that on your tour. That's not all yours.
True.
Yeah, because they're not going to the festival because the artists that are headlining the festival. People go to the festival because they go to the festival. You know, the artists change every single year. It doesn't matter if it's South by Southwest, AC3 or A3C, whatever it's called. All these big music festivals, people go to these festivals because they go to these festivals traditionally. And this idea that because you're headlining a festival, that people are coming because it's you headlining. No, it's the festival name. Like, people go to South by Southwest because the South by Southwest name, you know. And there's so many artists out there performing, unsigned, independent, major, you know. It's really the festival that's bringing it. So, like, once you go do your own tour, you got to stand on your 2 feet. That means your name has to bring it solely by itself. And that, who's running to go to the little baby tour?
There's a lot of names on that festival that they're here to see. It ain't necessarily you're the headliner, but everybody there is not there for you, and it can gas you. You know, you think you can sell out a bigger arena than you really can, or a bigger venue.
Well, even if they was, I'm still getting an accumulation of artists that I might like or just be all right with me, but I wouldn't mind seeing them.
Right.
I don't know if I'm gonna go spend $400 to see them.
Right.
Like, these tickets now are, like you said, this shit is starting to be a luxury item.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That shit is expensive, dog. Fucking Kane Brown tickets was like $400. Like, that shit is starting to be expensive. Beyonce selling out, that shit is expensive. Beyonce is a vacation. See,
and that's the alternative to us not striking. Because we still got to find an answer, right? How do we eat? How do we feed our families? The alternative to that is raising the price of music altogether. Which is...
They're already doing that, though. They're already raising the prices of all the streaming platforms. And that's the thing. Like, you can't charge the same amount for a song that you would charge for a two-hour movie. A five-minute song going to be the same price as a two-hour movie? No, that's... The solution is exclusivity. The solution is cut out the labels and make a direct deal with the streaming platform or something. Like, exclusively release it on one platform, or exclusively release it on your website, or do like the Samsung deal with Jay-Z. That's the thing. Raising the price of trash music, is it going to make people go run to buy the music more? You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of this music is trash. It's like, that's the thing. Like, a little baby concert shouldn't be a luxury item. It's trash. Like, I'm not paying $200 to go watch Little Baby perform. Trash. I mean, and then you got somebody saying his performance was okay. I'm not paying $200 for an okay performance. Because I can go pay a lot less for a Jordan Lucas performance and get an amazing performance.
Taking it from the fans. Mm-hmm. It's fucked up. But, yeah, music will be a luxury ticket item. Mm. Listen to your fucking thoughts and your silence.
Yeah, well, that would only work, Joe Buttons, if it was a lot of great music and good music out there. Trash music is not a luxury item. Trash music. And guess what? We don't got to listen to our thoughts. We could just say, screw your music and go watch a movie and listen to a podcast. You know, trash music is not a luxury item. Only great music and good music should be a luxury item. You know, so, and there's not a lot of great music and good music being put out.
Talk to your friends, stupid. Your family, nigga.
Fuck to the AC.
Read
sound.
A book.
Yeah, yeah, word. Hey, the smoke books detector that you ain't fucking fixed. Hum to that.
Shit isn't.
Get a little beat out of.
Not for nothing, too. This would be the time to strike. Because if you get T TV and music all shut down at the same time.
That's why I'm calling all of these people pussy, because this is how these things work.
You right.
You don't have to work together to work together.
Word.
All you got to do is see, oh, they doing that now. Oh, the actors joined.
Let's go.
Now.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's join in now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
See where you get your entertainment from.
Word.
All entertainment especially shut down.
Problem with that is there's a million motherfuckers trying to make it in music business. Rappers going on strike, musicians going on strike. There's a million motherfuckers trying to make it in the music business. There's a million, you know. And I'm not like raising the price. They're already raising the price of streaming platforms. You know, Spotify's raising the price. All of them raise the price. Apple Music's raised the price. Amazon, they've all raised the prices anyways. You know, what it is you need to be more exclusive. When you got, you distribute your music to 100 different platforms, that's 100 people that can take money out of your pocket at one time, you know. So let me play this last little bit.
Hip hop.
It'll be a whole lot of 99 bottles of beer on the wall.
Word.
99 bottles of beer.
Yeah. It's going to be a whole lot of Mary had a little lamb in around here. Hey, dust off your twister.
Talk about it.
Yo,
that's funny, but that's what the music is nowadays. That's what this rap music is just 99 bottles of beer on the wall. It's simple, basic shit. So that's already, yeah. The solution can't be pay more for trash. Pay more for shit. You know, you gotta pay more. You gotta put out better quality music. You know what I'm saying? Like that's the problem with the music business right now. They're not putting out. There's businesses that put out top notch quality and they're able to charge top notch prices. Music business is not. That's another thing with like. People, you know, bitching at streaming. I mean, yeah, I'm paying only so much for unlimited streaming, but there's not a lot of great music out there to stream unless I get into the 90s hip hop and early 2000s. A lot of the modern day hip hop, unless you know these underground artists, a lot of it's not really, really that good. So I'm not trying to pay more money for lesser quality music. But yeah, man, Lil Baby and a lot of these artists, they probably think they're bigger than they are just because of their streaming numbers. I mean, they're getting their streaming numbers mainly because they get added to a ton of these big Spotify playlists. And I think their fan base might be a little inflated, you know, some of these artists. And like they said, just because you headline a festival doesn't mean you can headline your own tour. Once again, I want to thank y'all for tuning in. Paul Pickett Podcast, and I'm out.